You were in prison for 18 years, yes, all told, 12 of those in solitary confinement on death row. How do you survive that, knowing that you have nothing to do with the crime you've been put away for?
Naivete saved my life, because I was just still naive to believe that somehow this was going to work out. And I refused to let that go.
Because you never gave up hope?
I never gave up hope, because the alternative was to realize that they would kill me.
Wasn't that hard to hold on to, Anthony, especially given the fact that they set a date for your execution not once, but twice?
Early on, I had said to myself that what these people can't take from me, I'm not going to give them. They couldn't take my dignity. They couldn't take my self-worth. I wasn't going to give it to them. You know?
In this fire-gutted house, firefighters found six bodies.
You're talking about four little babies asleep in their bed, a 16-year-old asleep in her bed, and their grandmother, who's also killed at the age of 45.
Anthony Graves was convicted of being an accomplice.
You're charged with the offense of capital murder.
Who? Capital murder? Me?
Are you sure? Me? You got the right person? They said, well, Mr. Carter already told us everything. Do you want to talk to us? I said, yes, I want to talk to you. Because I'm thinking, just you go back there and you talk to them. You know, they find out the truth, you go home. I spent 18 and a half years incarcerated for a crime that I did not commit. 16 and a half of those were in solitary confinement. A 6x9 cage. You walk three steps backwards, you're at the back of the wall. You walk three steps forward, you're at the front. I would hear guys in the middle of the night just get up and screaming because they're losing their mind.
Anthony Graves, carrying all of his belongings and looking a little dazed, walked out of jail and into the warm Texas sun.
Say, what you cooking tonight? Can you put something on? Because I'm on my way. This is your son. And just so you know, I did not escape.
And his first stop is home. To his sons who had grown up without him. And at long last, to an embrace with his mother.
Look at what I do today. In hindsight, I've been blessed.
I would be so angry and so bitter and so full of rage, Anthony.
See, that's why it didn't happen to you, it happened to me.
Thank goodness, because I would have
handled it. I try to let people know that no matter what you go through, no matter what you go through, you have a choice as to how you want to respond to it, negatively or positively. If you respond positive, you would definitely get some out of it, you know? And that's just what I try to do.